All right, Tristan. So you've been really good so far about practicing some of the things that you're afraid of doing because you're OCD. But if you really don't want to let OCD win, you have to kind of keep ramping it up. Remember we made your hierarchy a while back. Remember when we did that? Okay, so you've been really good so far about, like last week when you touched the doorknob and didn't wash your hands. That was really, really good. That's great. We just need to kind of keep it up and keep trying other things, okay?
Seriously.
Yeah. You can't just do some of the stuff. You can't just do some of the exposures and then, like, kind of talk your way through the other ones. That's really not how OCD operates.
But it feels better.
Yeah, I know. It's going to feel better in the short term when you do compulsions and when you do avoid, but you're just kind of making yourself more of a slave to OCD when you do that. So what we're going to have to keep doing is kind of keep doing the things on your exposure hierarchy. Do you think you're willing to do that?
Yeah, I think it's going to be all right. Got to try.
It might not be all right, but we're going to have to try it anyway.
Fuck you, no.
No, but seriously, you're not supposed to ever reassure. So,
okay.
So yeah, like, let's do that part.
Yeah.
You can keep the fuck you part in there.
That's good. That's good. Be awesome.
All right, so you've been really good so far with doing all that stuff, but we're going to have to keep going higher up the hierarchy. Do you think we can do that?
If you think that's okay, then I trust you.
Well, it might not be okay, right? But we are just going to have to see.
Okay. Got to
be okay. So do you remember what the next thing is on your hierarchy?
I do. I don't really want to say it, though.
Okay, maybe you think that might be something that you should try to say anyway?
Do I have to?
You don't have to do anything. But... okay, well, what is it? Do you remember?
Water fountain.
Okay, what about the water fountain?
You drink out of the water fountain.
Okay. What's your number right now just talking about that?
443.
Motherfucker, I'm talking about your SUDS number. Shit.
Is that the right thing, the water fountain? Drinking out of water
fountain? Yeah.
But I was getting you wrong.
No, you were right. That was good. That was good. Because that's what people always do. Even talking about it is actually an exposure for them. So.
Alright, so ask me about this again.
Okay, so what is your number even talking about this right now?
You know, SUDS number thing?
Yeah, what is your number is just talking about it?
Probably like 7, 8 maybe.
Okay. Yeah, because anything could happen, right? You can go out there and you can get some kind of disease from it. You have no idea.
Yeah, or worse.
Yeah, or worse, you might die, right? We're just going to have to go see. Okay, you want to go try it?
No, but I will.
All right, good. That's the right attitude. Let's go try it. Okay. All right.
It's kind of funny.
Oh, man.
Okay, so what's your number right now?
Like 8 or 9.
Okay, 8 or 9. What do you think would happen if you touched the handle?
I'd get jammed, man.
Okay, and what would that be like?
Be really gross.
Okay. Do you think you could try doing that? Awesome. Okay, great. So how does that feel?
Pretty gross.
Okay. Do you think you can keep your hand on there for longer and not just pull it away? Okay, just hold it there. So what's that like?
It's not great.
What do you think your number is?
10.
It's a 10?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's just stand here for a second. So what's going to happen now that you touch that?
I don't know. I might get sick or something.
Yeah, you might. You might. That's just going to be something you're going to have to take the risk of happening. So what would happen if you took a sip out of there?
At this point, I don't know if it could get any worse.
Okay. So why don't you try doing that and see what happens? Okay, awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, so what's your number now?
I don't know, 9. I don't feel as bad.
Yeah, I mean, anything could happen now that you've drunk that you could get some kind of disease, you could get like cholera or something, right? Isn't that possible?
Yeah. Okay. I just feel like now that I've done it, just, I don't know, it's not as bad.
It's not as bad as before when
still,
you're thinking about
it? Yeah, it sucks, but it's not scary.
Okay. Well, we're going to keep trying it, and we're going to keep doing more and more things on your hierarchy, and then you can see we're not going to let it see.